He's bright. He's got a real clever sense of humor and quick mind. He's very, he plays goalie. He's cool under pressure. All these things give me hope that if there's an opportunity, this boy will be home.
Is he a survivor?
He's a survivor.
He had a gun and he told us to turn around and go over into this ditch and put our bikes in there and lay down. Then he came over and he asked us all our ages, and then he told Trevor to run as fast as he could into the woods or else he'd shoot. Then he looked at me and then he grabbed Jacob and he told me to run as fast as I could into the woods or he'd shoot.
What did this man look like?
Well, he was all in black. He had a mask on him.
You couldn't see his face?
Uh-uh. He had a nylon mask or some kind of mask.
Did Jacob say anything to the man?
Uh-uh. Just his age.
When you ran, did you look back?
Yeah, once we got way down there.
What did you see?
Nothing. No, he wasn't there anymore.
Are you lost? Will I find you?
Ritual every time I get on a plane, you know, can you hear us? We're here. There was a singer-songwriter who wrote a song, Jacob's Hope, and the verse goes, and Jacob, can you hear us? We send you our prayers. We send you all our strength and our love. We're not giving up till we bring you back home. We are Jacob's Hope. And I go through this ritual. Somebody's sitting next to me. I just tell him to be quiet. This is my time, and I look out the window, and it's like he's somewhere, and somebody knows something.
Of a sacred place, I'd come down here and just be. It really is hard for a while to sit back and analyze everything I've, quote, done, because it doesn't third.
Looking back, you know, me and Jacob are the same age. We both look alike. And it's pitch black, and you probably couldn't really see our faces. And so, you know, I always had to live with that. You know, I was the last person, you know, with him. That's 50-50 odds as far as, you know, me or him. You know, why did he choose him and not me? I mean, Jacob was a great person, you know, and so you have that guilt of, he should be here and I shouldn't be here. And that's something that I would say I still probably live with to this point, you know.
Today, October 12th, I'm 5 feet tall. My whole name is Jacob Irvin Wetterling. My favorite food is steak. My favorite color is blue. My best friend is Aaron Larson. My favorite, I don't really have a favorite song. My favorite game is Clue. My favorite thing to do most is watch football. My favorite sport is football. My favorite TV show is a comedy show. What I want to be when I grow up is a football player. My favorite hobby is collecting football cards. I don't have a favorite book, and my newest friend is Gabe.
When you have a child, you make this promise to them. You will be there. You'll be there. And that's what we're trying to do, still be there.